शुड आई स्टार्ट मैम? हेलो,
यस मैम।
ओके, थैंक यू. ओके, गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स. माई सेल्फ कल्पना विनोद जाधव फ्रॉम सेवका नगर स्कूल. लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द टूडेज टॉपिक, दैट इज द रिविजन लेक्चर ऑफ इफेक्ट्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करंट of paper 1, science and technology paper 1. So let us start with the fourth lesson, effects of electric current. So which are the learning objectives of this chapter? Before that, please take out your textbook and notebook also with you. Note down all the important points of this chapter. Okay, take a screenshot of the PPTs and note down all the important points in your notebook. So learning objectives of today's topic, first is discuss about the forms of energy and terms related to it, then to understand the concept of simple electric circuit. After that, discuss the terms of short circuit and the overloading. Then discuss the concept of magnetic field, magnetic lines and magnetic force. Also, this chapter includes the objective, that is the discuss about the relation between the electric current and magnetic field. Next is to understand the concept of right and thumb rule. In this chapter, we will learn about the topic, that is the Fleming's left hand rule and Fleming's right hand rule also, and which are the principle of electric motor and also the electric generator. So some points are there also, that is the solenoid, what is meant by the solenoid, then what is the principle working and construction of electric motor and electric generator. So let us start with this revision of this chapter. So first is what, how does the electrons flow? So you know, though this chapter includes that, if that point, that is the effects of electric current means what? What is meant by the current? What is the medium of the current? So what is the medium of the current? That is your conductor. So what is mean that conductor? What is the conductor? That is nothing but it is a metal. It is made up of the metal, some metal. Now metal is what? The metal which is good conductor of heat and electricity. Now what is the metal which, what is exactly metal which having some electrons, protons and neutrons, means what? It is having some atoms. So this metal, this conductor is nothing but the which having some negative charge. So current where it gets flows circuit. This is called a circuit. Okay, so this diagram indicates the complete circuit. There is a flow of electrons from negative terminal to positive terminal of this cell. So this is your flow of electrons. That is your introductory part of this chapter. Now next point is what? This is your simple circuit. This is a simple electric circuit where there is a copper wire, there is a battery, there is cell, switch and light bulb, right? So an electric circuit is closed path formed by the interconnection of electric components through which an electric current can flow. So these are the electric components, which are, that is your battery, switch, wire, that conductor, battery cell. All these are the electric components. So for the complete your circuit, it required, okay? So an electric circuit is closed path formed by interconnection of the electric components. So there is an interconnection of electric components, okay? So flow of electron is there. Look at the diagram. There is an arrow indicates that is the flow of electrons from negative terminal to positive terminal, okay? So this is your simple electric circuit. Now let us start with the main important topic of this lesson, that is the heating effect of electric current. So what is meant by the heating effect of electric current? So in this chapter, we included a topic that is the heating effect of electric current and magnetic effect of electric current. So first of all, we will start about the heating effect of heating effect of electric current. So what is meant by the heating effect of electric current? So when a resistor is connected in an electrical circuit, heat is produced due to the current. Important point is there. When a resistor is connected in an electrical circuit, so heat is produced because of the current. There is a large amount of current which is flows through the electric circuit and it produces some amount of heat. So that effect is nothing but the heating effect of electric current. Okay. Now some examples are there. That is your heater, then electric cooker, after that iron. Okay, so water boiler, some examples are there. It consists of some coil. That coil, it is made up of alloy. Example is nichrome. So alloy nichrome is used in electric heater or cooker. Okay. So as a resistor. So nichrome wire, that is alloy. This alloy is used as a resistor. So what is the function of this resistor? When this resistor is connected in an electrical circuit, it produces the heat. So it produces the heat. So it produces the heat when if we supply the current through the conductor. Okay. So this alloy, that is the nichrome wire, is used which produces the heat. Okay. So it is used in electric heater, cooker, iron, so geyser. So this alloy, that is nichrome, is used as a resistor. It helps to produce the heat. So these are the examples, and alloy nichrome is used. Now what about the tungsten wire? Tungsten wire is used in our bulb. That our regular bulb is there. In that bulb, the tungsten wire is used. Okay. So electric bulb where the tungsten wire is used. Why this tungsten wire is used? Because this wire gets heated nearly about 3400 degrees Celsius. Okay. So when we supply the current through this wire, the wire gets heated up to 3400 degrees Celsius and it emits the light. Okay. So tungsten wire is used in electric bulb. So next, what about the next? Now, look at this diagram, how light bulb works. So this is the construction where this is the filament. It filament is nothing but the tungsten filament. Okay. So electric current flows from one contact to another contact. So this wire, when it heats up, means when the current is flows through the conductor, the electron passes through the filament. And the tungsten wire heated up to 3400 degrees Celsius, and it emits light. Okay, so tungsten wire. Remember this: nichrome wire is an alloy which is used in electric heater, electric cooker. But the tungsten wire is used in electric bulb. Okay, now next is what? Next is, what about the short circuit? What is the potential? This all these three wires are coated with the plastic. Now plastic coating, it is covered with the plastic coating. Why? Because plastic covering or plastic coating is required because plastic is a insulator. It is an insulator. So to avoid the short circuit, we use this wire which is having plastic coating. Now what will happen if you remove the plastic coating? If we remove the plastic coating, what will happen when the live and neutral wires comes in contact with each other? There is a large amount of current flows through it and producing the heat. So large amount of current will be flows. It produces the large amount of heat, and that is nothing but your short circuit. Okay. So to avoid this short circuit, we use the fuse wire as a precautionary measures. When the large amount of current it flows in the circuit, the fuse wire get melt. It melts and it break up the circuit. Okay. So these are the three wires. First is live, second is neutral, and third is earth wire. Remember this. The live and neutral wires have potential difference, that is 220 volt. To avoid the short circuit, fuse wire is used as a precautionary measure when the large amount of heat is produced because of the high amount of current get flows. When the live and neutral wire comes in contact with each other. When it comes in contact with each other, when there is no plastic coating on the live wire and neutral wire. So when the bare live and neutral wire comes in contact with each other, it generates the large amount of current, and there is nothing but the short circuit. And to avoid the short circuit, we use the fuse wire. So fuse wire, it is made up of a tin and lead. That metal, that is the tin and lead. Why? Because it having the low melting point. So lead, tin and lead, that metal having the low melting point. That's why fuse wire is used. Avoid the short circuit, or it is also used as a precautionary measures. Okay. Now next, what is meant by the overloading? So what is meant by the overloading? When large amount of heat is produced or excessive current is drawn from the transformer supplying the electricity, and if the capacity of transformer is insufficient, its fuse wire melts and supply gets shut down. That is nothing but the overloading. So definition of overloading. So excessive amount of excessive or large amount of current is drawn from the transformer supplying the electricity. So there is a beyond excessive current which is drawn from the transformer. Okay. So if the capacity of transformer is insufficient, the fuse wire melts, and that is nothing but the overloading. सम काइंड ऑफ एमसीपी दैट इज द मिनिएचर सर्किट ब्रेकर्स आर यूज इन होम्स टू अवॉइड द शॉर्ट सर्किट टू अवॉइड द ओवरलोडिंग. ओके सो दीज आर द इलेक्ट्रिक फ्यूज, दीज आर द एमसीपीज विच आर यूज टू अवॉइड द शॉर्ट सर्किट. सो इलेक्ट्रिक फ्यूज इज सेफ्टी डिवाइस यूज इन इलेक्ट्रिक सर्किट which protects the electrical circuit and appliances and prevent fire. Okay, so take a screenshot this PPT. First is what is the application of electric fuse. Okay, so first is what is the function. So first is what, it protects the electrical circuits and appliances and prevents the fire. Electrical fuse is used in all electrical circuits in buildings. Electric fuse has wire which melts quickly and breaks the circuit. Okay, so it avoids the flow of current, large amount of flow of current it avoids. So these are the next second diagram indicates the MCBs, that is the miniature circuit breakers, which is used in home. When the current in the circuit suddenly increases, the switch opens and current stops. So different type of MCBs are used in our household work. Now next is what about the magnetic effect of electric current. So first is what, first we have seen that is the heating effect. Now second is what, magnetic effects of electric current. Now let us start with the magnetic effects of electric current. So magnetic effects of electric current means what? So magnetic effect, what is meant by the magnet? Magnet is nothing but the, we know the magnet which having the So we know the magnet, that is the attraction between the unlike poles, and there is a repulsion between the like poles. So already we have learned. Your activity plays the magnet. Okay. So the region around the magnet where it's force. Why the curve path? The curve path of this iron filing indicates there is some force which is indicate, that is the some force means what? That is your magnetic force. The magnet applies the some force on the iron filing. So that is nothing but the, and indicates that is the magnetic field. So region around the magnet where its force can be felt is known as the magnetic field. Why does the iron filing forms a pattern? Due to the force exerted by the magnet. So this magnet exerts some amount of force and it creates its magnetic field, and all the iron filings are arranged in a curved path. Okay, so that force which is exerted by the magnet, and it creates that lines nothing but the magnetic lines of force. So due to the force exerted by the magnet, the iron filings arrange themselves in a pattern as shown above. Okay, so that lines which is indicated in a curve path, that lines are nothing but the magnetic lines of force, and these magnetic lines of force which are created because why? That is because only the force which is exerted by the magnet. So now, how is the magnetic field represented? So magnetic field which is represented, the area around the magnet where the magnetic force is experienced is called as magnetic field. Okay, So magnetic field, which indicates that curve path is nothing but your magnetic field. So magnetic field lines means what? The force which is exerted by the magnet, which creates the curve path. So that is your magnetic lines of force. Next, which are the properties of magnetic field lines? They do not intersect each other. Now look at that diagram. All the lines, these are parallel to each other and they do not intersect with each other. It is taken by the convention that magnetic field lines emerge from North Pole and merge at South Pole. So remember, this is the important point. These are the properties of magnetic field lines. So first is what? That the magnetic lines of force do not intersect with each other. And second point is what? All the magnetic field lines are created from the North Pole and merge at the South Pole. Okay. And inside the magnet, look at the diagram, that inside the magnet, there is a direction is from South Pole to North Pole. So this is very, very important point. Now, next is what? Magnetic field produced around the conductor. So this is your cardboard. This is your activity. We shown the magnetic lines, which how the magnetic field lines created. So first is when the current is passed through the conductor, what about the magnetic field? What will happen when we pass the current? We pass the current in a straight line conductor. When we pass the current in a straight line conductor, the magnetic field is produced around it. Now, this diagram indicates that when there is a straight line conductor, and if the current is passed through the straight line conductor, then magnetic field which is produced around it, the iron filings, when we spread the iron filings are on the cardboard, all these are arranged, all these iron filings are arranged in a concentric circles, okay? So this circles indicates the magnetic lines of force. And if you switch up the current, means if the current is unchanged, the magnetic field reduces as the distance from the wire increases. So concentric circle represents the magnetic lines of force are shown bigger and rarefied as the distance from the wire increases. If the current through the wire increases, the intensity of magnetic field line increases. So important point is what? If the current through the wire is increases, the intensity of magnetic field also increases. So concentric circles, the arrangement of concentric circle is indicate that there is an intensity. It shows the intensity of magnetic field, or it shows the intensity of magnetic lines of force, and it behaves. Or here we apply the right hand thumb rule. Now, what is meant by the right hand thumb rule? Let us have a look about the right hand thumb rule. So what is meant by the right hand thumb rule? A question may be asked, state the right hand thumb rule, or diagram may be given and question may be asked, draw or label the diagram, okay, or state the right hand thumb rule. Now this is your right hand thumb rule. What is the right hand thumb rule? That if you point your thumb in sorry if you and curve is in upward direction. clockwise direction. So right hand thumb rule, that means what? Your thumb points in the direction of the current if it indicates in upward direction. Okay, and this conductor, when you curve your fingers around the conductors, it shows the direction of the magnetic lines of force. Now look at this diagram. When the thumb in upward direction, the magnetic direction of the magnetic lines of force are always in anticlockwise direction. And if your thumb direction is in downward, so all the magnetic lines of force are in clockwise direction. So right hand thumb rule, if the current carrying conductors, straight line conductor is held in your right hand such that the thumb points towards the direction of the current and then wrap the fingers shows the direction of the magnetic field lines. So this is your right hand thumb rule. Now next is what? When the magnetic field line, which is produced when the conductor is in circular loop. In first topic, we have seen in previous slide, we have seen that if the current carrying conductor is in straight line, it is in straight position. But if the current carrying conductor, it is in circular loop, so what will happen about the magnetic lines of force? So this is your conductor which is in circular loop. Every point of loop forms large number of concentric circles. So if you pass the current through the conductor, so each loop having concentric magnetic lines of force. The circles are smaller near the wire and bigger as we move away from the wire. At the center of the loop, the arc of these circles appears as a straight lines because of very large amount of radius. So radius is there, so very large radius of the circle that indicates the arc of these magnetic lines. Now next, again, the magnetic lines. First point, when there is a circular loop, the magnetic lines of force, the magnetic field which increases when the current flowing through the coil increases, first point. Second point is what? When the magnetic field increases as the number of turns of coil increases. Third point is what? Magnetic field decreases as the radius of the coil increases. So these three points are very important. So please take a screenshot of this PPT and note down all these points in your notebook. Now next is what? Next about the solenoid. What is meant by the solenoid? Solenoid is nothing but the when a copper wire with a resistive coating is wound in a chain of loops. So it likes the spring. Spring-like structure is there, that is your copper wire. So it is nothing but the solenoid. So when copper wire with the resistive coating is wound in a chain of loops, it is called as solenoid. And solenoid behaves like a bar magnet. When current pass through it, when we pass the current through the copper wire, it behaves like a bar magnet. Okay. Now, this is your solenoid coil. When we pass the current through the solenoid coil, so there is a, if that solenoid is behaves like a magnet. If the solenoid behaves like a magnet, it also produces the magnetic force. It also produces the magnetic lines of force. It creates the magnetic lines of force. So magnetic field lines start from the North Pole to South Pole, right? It all these magnetic lines start from the North Pole and enters into the South Pole. Enters, that is merge into the South Pole. Second point is what? Two magnetic lines of force that never intersect with each other. In previous slide, we have seen that when we spread the iron filings, what will happen? All these magnetic lines are start from the North Pole and enters into the South Pole. Second point, all these magnetic lines are never intersect with each other. third point, inside the magnet, the field lines moves from south to north pole inside the magnet. Remember this, inside the magnet, the field lines start from south to north pole. And fourth point is, the magnetic lines of force are crowded near the pole. Okay, so all the magnetic lines are crowded near the pole. So these are the important points of magnetic field which is produced due to the solenoid. Now next is what? Solenoid, we know the solenoid, we know the pattern of magnetic field. So these are very, very important points. What is meant by the solenoid? Question may be asked, what is meant by the solenoid, or define the solenoid? Okay, and which are the characteristics of magnetic field pattern or magnetic field produced due to the solenoid? We know the right hand thumb rule. The curved fingers here it applies the principle of right hand thumb rule. On placing the conductor in the direction of the magnetic field, there is no displacement in it. So when the current enters the space between the particular two directions, so it indicates the direction of magnetic field, it indicates the direction of the current carrying conductor. Okay, so here we apply the principle of right hand thumb rule. So again, that activity which indicates, in short, whenever a current is not flowing through wire, it remains straight at point A. Okay, but if you flow the current through the conductor from bottom to top, the wire bends and comes into point B, that is on your left side. But if we flow the current from top to bottom, the wire bends and comes into position, that is C, that is on your right side. So the direction of force of wire is always perpendicular to the magnetic field and the direction of current. Now students, here fourth point that indicates the direction of force on a wire perpendicular to the both magnetic field and direction of current. So force is perpendicular to magnetic field and the direction current. So whenever current flows through the conductor in the presence of magnetic field and the force is exerted on the conductor and all these are perpendicular to each other. So conduct by magnetic field, direction of current and the magnetic lines of force, these three points, that is force, magnetic field and direction of current, all these are perpendicular to each other, it applies on the principle that is the Fleming's left hand rule. So here it shows the Fleming's principle. It is already based on the principle of Fleming's left hand rule. So what is the Fleming's left hand rule? That is, if you stretch the thumb, forefinger and center finger of the left hand mutually perpendicular to each other, the forefinger in the direction of the magnetic field, the middle finger in the direction of the current, and thumb will point in the direction of the force acting on the conductor. So look at your diagram, that all these are the perpendicular to each other. So in previous slide that we have seen the activity, this activity based on the principle that is the Fleming's left stand rule. Okay. So if you stretch your thumb, so what is your Fleming's left hand rule? If you stretch the thumb, forefinger and your center finger or your middle finger of the left hand mutually perpendicular to each other. So forefinger indicates the direction of magnetic field, middle finger indicates the direction of the current, and your thumb points the direction of the force acting on the conductor. Okay, this is your Fleming's left hand rule. Now next is what is the principle construction and working of electric motor? Now student, this is your electric motor, which is based on the principle that a motor is a device which converts electrical energy into mechanical energy. Okay, so first is that what is mean by the electric motor, or define the electric motor. So electric motor is the device which converts electrical energy into mechanical energy. Okay, if we supply the current, it converts the electrical energy into the mechanical energy. Okay, principle of motor, principle of electric motor is what? A motor works on a principle that when a rectangular coil is placed in a magnetic field, a current is passed through it. So coil is placed in a magnetic field and the current is passed through it. A force acts on the coil which rotates it continuously. Okay. So it is the principle. This is your principle of electric motor. And what about the working? The working is what? When the electric current is passed into the rectangular coil. So this is your rectangular coil, that is the axle. This is the split rings, brushes, and it having the two magnet, that is indicating the north and south pole. So when the electric current is passed into the rectangular coil, this current produces a magnetic field. So this current is produced the magnetic field, and because of that only the electric motor, that axle, get rotating continuously. So this current is produced a magnetic field around the coil. Now the current through the conductor, for example, solenoid coil, which is a copper wire, it is wound in a loop like structure, so chain like structure, spring like structure. It is made up of magnet. It made is nothing but the electromagnet, because it behaves like a bar magnet when we supply the electricity. So electro means electricity, magnet, it behaves like a magnet. The soft metal core made into the magnet by the passage of electric current through a coil surround it. So that is nothing but the electromagnet. Now what about the electromagnetic induction? So process by which changing magnetic field in a conductor induces the current in another conductor. So two conductors are there. First conductor, where we changes the magnetic field because of the bypassing the electric current. When we supply the electric current to the first conductor, it induces the current into another conductor. Okay. So that is nothing but the induction. So process by which changing magnetic field in conductor induces a current in another conductor is called electromagnetic induction. So definition of electromagnetic induction is very, very important. It induces the current to another conductor. Okay. So two conductors are there. The process by which changing the magnetic field in a conductor induces the current in another conductor. So that is called as electromagnetic induction. Okay, now electromagnetic induction, the induction can be detected by the galvanometer. Galvanometer is used to detect the current only. Okay, so electromagnetic induction, generation of current in a coil due to the relative motion between the coil and the magnet. So relative motion between the coil and the magnet. So observe the diagram, it having the bar magnet, the coil is there, right? That is your conductor. The motion of the magnet with respect to a coil produces induced current. So moment of the coil, if you move this magnet towards or away from the coil, there is a deflection in galvanometer. So if a magnet is moved towards or away from a coil of a wire connected to a galvanometer, the galvanometer needle shows the deflection. And this shows that the current is induced in a coil due to the motion of the magnet. So first is what? Motion of the magnet with respect to coil produces induced current. When you move the magnet towards or away from the coil, there is some deflection in the galvanometer. It indicates that current is induced in a coil due to the movement of the magnet. Now, second point is what? Now, next is what? There is a Faraday's law of induction. It indicates the principle of electromagnetic induction. So, what is meant by the Faraday's law of induction? Faraday's law of induction. Now, here, two copper wires are there or two conductors are there. First conductor, which indicates there is a complete circuit. When we pass the electric current through the first conductor, it induces the current to the next conductor. So, whenever the number of magnetic lines of force passing through a coil changes the current and is it induced in a coil. So, when we pass the current through the first conductor, it creates some magnetic lines of force and it induces the current to the next conductor. So, what is meant by the Faraday's law of induction? So whenever the number of magnetic lines of force passing through the coil changes, the current is induced in a coil. This is called as Faraday's law of induction. And the current produced in the coil is called as induced current. So current is produced in what? Which coil? That second number. So current is produced in a second number coil and that current is nothing but your induced current. So if a current is switched on or off in a solenoid coil, a current is induced in that coil, such as the induction is observed. And when the current in the solenoid coil is increases or decreases, the current is induced in a coil when is moved aside from the front of the solenoid. This experiment is nothing but the Faraday's law of induction. Okay. Now, this Faraday's law of induction is based on the principle of Fleming's right-hand rule. Now, what is meant by the Fleming's right-hand rule? In previous slide, we have seen the Fleming's and your middle finger of right and middle finger shows the direction. Electric generator, which converts the mechanical energy into the electric energy, is called as electric generator. So here we use the principle, it is based on the Faraday's right hand rule, sorry, Fleming's right hand rule. That is, here there is an induced current. So mechanical energy is converting to electrical energy. The principle of electric generator, that is, works on the principle of electromagnetic induction. When a coil of electric generator rotates in a magnetic field, the magnetic field induces the current into the coil. And this induced current then flows into the circuit connected to the coil. So this electric generator is based on the principle of Fleming's right hand rule, where it induces the current to the coil and the coil gets rotated. So electric generator is based on the principle of electromagnetic induction. And remember, electric motor is based on the principle of Fleming's left hand rule. Now, students, question may be asked, write the difference between the Fleming's left hand rule, sorry, Fleming's left and right hand rule. Okay. So difference is what? The Fleming's left hand rule and Fleming's right hand rule. The first important difference, that is, in Fleming's left hand rule, it is used to determine the direction of the magnetic force. Where Fleming's right hand rule, it is used to determine the direction of induced electric current. Okay. Next is middle finger signifies the electric current. It is in Fleming's left hand rule. So in Fleming's left hand rule indicates that middle finger signifies the electric current. And Fleming's right hand rule, where the middle finger indicates the induced current. It signifies the induced current. Okay. Next is Fleming's left hand rule, that is, the thumb signifies the direction of magnetic force, where Fleming's right hand rule, that is, thumb signifies the direction of motion of conductor. Okay. Now, where the Fleming's left hand rule apply, that is, it is used in electric motor, while the Fleming's right hand rule, it is applied on, that is, in electric generator. So this is the difference between the Fleming's left hand rule and Fleming's right hand rule. Now next is difference between the electric motor and the electric generator. So remember, student, question may be asked on electric motor, that is, the right principle working of electric motor, or which are or the uses of the electric motor, examples of the electric motor, where it is used, or at what principle it is based on. So what is the difference between the electric motor and electric generator? Also, for the draw and label the diagram. Okay, this such type of question may be asked for the electric motor and the electric generator. So first question, first difference for the electric motor and electric generator is what? So first, we know that it converts in electric motor is the machine which converts the electrical energy to mechanical energy. If you pass the conduct current through the conductor, the coil gets rotating because of current. Okay, so electrical energy, it converts the electrical energy into mechanical energy. While the in electric generator, the electric generator is a device that converts the mechanical energy to electrical energy. Second point is what? The electric motor follows the Fleming's left hand rule. Okay, so current is flow. We know the all three fingers are perpendicular to each other, but main difference is what? In Fleming's left hand rule, that indicates the flow of current, and in Fleming's right hand rule, that signifies the flow of induced current. Okay, so Fleming's right hand rule, it applies on electric generator. So electric generator follows the Fleming's right hand rule. Next point is what? So in electric motor works on a principle, current carrying conductor placed in a magnetic field experiences forces. If we supply the current to the conductor, it experiences the magnetic field, it produces the magnetic field lines of force, there is the magnetic lines of force it creates. While in electric generator, it works on the principle of electromagnetic induction. So this is very, very important point. Now, student, next is what? The current is supplied to the armature winding. So current is supplied. Because electric motor is that is the Now, electric generators in power stations, generators are used in lift when power cut up there. So what will happen? We use the lift. So generators are there. So where we use the electric generator. So this is the difference between the electric motor and electric generator. Okay. So students, in this chapter, the questions are you asked to explain the constructions and working of the electric motor or electric generator. So, or what is meant by the electromagnetic induction, or define the electromagnetic induction, or why the tungsten metal is used. So tungsten metal, which is having the low melting point, and tungsten metal, which is used in electric bulb. Why the tungsten metal is used in electric bulb? No, it is having the high melting point, that is the 3400 degrees Celsius. So tungsten metal, which is used in electric bulb, why the fuse wire is used to avoid the short circuit. So which metal is used? That is the lead and the tin metal, which is used in fuse wire, which having the lower melting point. Okay. Also the some questions may be asked, that is the for electric power transmission. The copper or aluminum wire is used. So these are the good conductor of electricity. So we use the copper and aluminum wire for the electric power transmission. Okay, so electrons get moved from the negative terminal to positive terminal. So such kind of questions may be asked in this chapter. Also, what is meant by the solenoid or diagram may be asked, that is the Fleming's left hand rule and Fleming's right hand rule, or explain the Fleming's right hand rule and left hand rule, or state the right hand thumb rule. Right hand thumb rule state, or draw the draw and label the diagram of right hand thumb rule. Okay. Also the diagram of MCB. Identify for the identification of the diagram. Explain the term or explain the difference between the electric motor and electric generator, and also the Fleming's left hand rule and right hand rule. Okay. So such type of questions may be asked in this chapter. So student, this is your homework. Take out the screenshot of this your homework. So here are some questions here. So first is, what do you mean by the induced current? What is meant by the induced current? Or definition, define the Fleming's left hand rule and right hand rule. And now student, third question, that is the Maxwell corkscrew rule. That is nothing but your right hand thumb rule. Maxwell corkscrew rule is nothing but the right hand thumb rule. Okay. Next is, define the Faraday's law of induction, or why the carbon brushes are used, how to use, what is the use of carbon brushes, or what is the use of split rings. So two types of rings, that is the split rings and also spilled rings in a electric generator. So small questions will be asked in this chapter. This is your next, that is the draw and label the diagram, describe the pattern of the magnetic lines of force due to the current through the circular loop. So what is meant by the short circuit, or what is meant by the overloading? Define the short circuit, or explain the overloading. Why, what do you mean by the earthing? Okay, so name the components of device which is used for the safety measures of electrical gadgets. So fuse wire, which is used as a safety measures for the short circuit. Now give the reason why the material which is used for making the fuse wire has low melting point, right? So it break up the circuit easily. It has the lower melting point, so it break up the circuit. Okay, so to avoid the short circuit, we use the fuse wire as a precautionary measure. Okay, so such type of questions may be asked. Take a screenshot of these two slides. First homework slides. These are the two homework slides, first and second. Okay, thank you, students. Hello.
Hello. Thank you.